Best of r/entitledparents episode 48. So I work in a small tapas restaurant. It's a really nice place, we get great reviews, and the restaurant acts as a kind of hub for the local community. I love working there as everyone who I work with is great. About a month ago, EM and her roughly over a year old baby, B, come into our restaurant. We have no problem with them at all. They come in, eat, pay and leave. About 2 days later, a horrible review comes in on TripAdvisor for the restaurant about how their child was injured and had to go to hospital. This was confusing for the owners as they had no information about this happening. Later that day, an angry email comes in saying about how their bee's hand was burnt by the overly hot food. The manager who was on shift sent back an email asking for their reservation and other information. EM did just that, but then stated that if she doesn't receive compensation, she will sue us. Our manager pulls up the security camera footage for the time that they said it happened. On the footage, it clearly shows EM holding a fry in front of their baby who grasps onto it and then begins to cry. Obviously not our fault. The story ends with our manager sending EM the footage and us not getting a reply since. Just an overall rude EM who threatens to sue us and didn't have the balls to tell a waiter what happened or contact us in a friendlier way and try to sort something out. Thank you. Next. So, first things first, I'm not from US, so pardon my English. And I don't know if this is a right subreddit, but there was definitely an EM in this case. But I simply don't know where else would I tell this. So this story is old at this point. I'm currently 21 years old and just finished my university, but this story was 16-17 years ago. I was a little kid during the class that takes place right after kindergarten. Here it's called introductorio, and there was a kid who was abnormally big compared to the rest of the class. Me and my twin brother studied in the same class and we both sat side by side. But for some reason, some teacher decided that it was a good idea to put this guy to sit right on my side, the opposite side of where my brother was sitting. I didn't think much of this as a kid, cause as a kid I just wanted to play with my toys and sit on my chair. I didn't have many friends back then and my brother was my main source of conversation, but I really liked singing to myself back then. This kid adored messing with people around him. One time he got my brother and started lifting his whole body by his neck. He was known for fighting with other kids and adored sharpen a pencil and just repeatedly false stab kids' eyes. I think you know where this is going. One day I was in my chair painting something, and how I love humming musics I like, even to this day, I did exactly that, and this kid simply started trying to stab kids' eyes again. When suddenly I hear he imitating me, and when I look at him, I see a pencil basically inches from the center of my right eye, much closer than he usually did. I tried moving my head but with no avail. He hit the left side of my right eye. At first he just started laving as the pencil point just fell off, then the blood came out. As a kid I just started crying and screaming. My teacher came to me trying to open my eye, and how it was full of blood. I can clearly remember that I simply couldn't see anything besides blood, but hey, I could see. That's a positive. When the theater finally calmed me down, she realized that he missed my eye. The kid was in shock. My eye was still bleeding and both my mom and EM were called for the school. After that they took me to the closest thing to an infirmary my school had. That's where they realized that my sharp move was the only reason I was not blind. My eye was intact, just with a lot of blood. Then EM gets there, and I can easily remember how she said that her angel couldn't have done such thing and how I should have hurt my eye elsewhere, pointing and shouting at me, and this kid right by her side. This went on for a while, with the mom basically denying and protecting his kid at all costs. After some time the kid simply came to me and apologized himself. Right after that the kid is suspended for like 3 days and my mom gets to the school and pick me up. With my eye finally stopping bleeding, my teacher explains the situation and I just go home. My mom is not the type to start trouble, so how I was fine and my vision was intact, she just let it go. And TBH, I actually feel bad for the kid. When I saw him, he was destroyed, basically blasting into tears, and after this incident, he actually became much more controlled in the room, and next time I saw him he actually apologized again, and basically left most of my class alone for next 3 months until his was transferred, and I never heard from him since. Sorry if there is just too little of EP here. If there is, let me know, I'll delete the post and find somewhere else to post it. TL. Doctor, kid almost hit my eye with a sharp pencil. Moms get mad defending his angel. Thank you. Next. I don't know, man, I just don't get how people feel it's okay to think we're some free babysitting service. Me and my grandparents live in the same building and some relatives come over and leave their little kid upstairs with us, while they head downstairs and chill with our grandparents. He comes in and immediately he's screaming almost constantly like he's a horror let's player, demands colors from my mom and sister, demands the best colors my sister has, she's in art school, she kinda actually needs those, starts coloring, and every time a color doesn't work he yells at my mom to fix it. He gets bored after like 3 minutes. I was just vibbing in my living room, playing Tetris on my laptop, and this kid comes over and goes, "What you playing?" And at this point I'm like, okay, I'll let him watch, cause he's not being annoying to me thus far. He's just sitting there calling out the Tetrises and generally not being a shithead, so I'm like, alright, maybe this kid is alright, just a bit hyperactive. This kid then proceeds to go behind me where I was sitting on the couch and wrap around my neck like a koala. Starts putting his head in front of my laptop so I can't see the game. Starts pressing buttons on the keyboard, yelling in my ear, like directly in my ear. He made sure he was as close as possible, smacking me from both sides of my face. The little shit fell down from the little koala hold he had my neck in and almost snapped my laptop in half. And at this point, you know, I'm kinda tilted, but I'm not about to smack someone's kid. This little shit is 5/6 and I'm 19, so God knows I'll probably get in trouble for it. So I just start talking shit to the kid. "You know, you're really annoying. Do your parents smack you? I'm gonna tell them to smack you when you get home. Little demon, don't cry." He kept hanging onto my leg while I'm trying to get water, pulling on my hoodie while I'm trying to walk around. Eventually I realized I can actually just lock myself in my room. Little shit tried to follow, but I pushed him away before going in. No way I'm letting him near any of my consoles. I have like 5 DSs in my room and I appreciate having them all in one piece. At the end of the day I am tilted but very impressed with myself. I have the patience of a monk. That kid deserved a right smack but I held out. I just wonder what the fuck his parents were thinking. This is why you should beat your kids, everyone. One day someone might not be as patient as me and do it for you. Thank fuck I was not an only child. Moral of the story, I'm getting a vasectomy soon. Thank you. Next. A few years ago I was living with my brother and his family. A neighbor kid came over to play in the backyard with my nephews. Everything was fine, all quiet, and then the front door opens. The neighbor kid's dad opened the door and walked through the house to tell his kid to come home. I sat on the sofa, struck dumb, as he collected the kid and left. He didn't even say a single word to me. There was nothing stopping this man from calling his kid from over the fence, yet he took the liberty of walking into someone else's house without even a knock. My brother and sister-in-law did not know the family beyond the casual good morning, so there was no reason for him to think this was acceptable. I just, what? Thank you. Next. Hey kids, today I have a story for you all. The cast goes as follows. A/me, Morgan Freeman M, entitled Momek. Stupid little shit, I want to kick C, the cook. So, this was on a Boy Scout trip over a couple of nights. This happened on the first night, where the group traveled from Philadelphia to a campground in Maryland. The group consisted of about 16 scouts and leaders spread out amongst 4 cars. Different cars were used to carry different necessary supplies, and the car piloted by M was the one carrying all the food that we were to cook in the cabin that weekend. The rest of the caravan arrived in Maryland around the same time, with the notable exception of M and Eck. At first it wasn't noticeable, but was soon evident when boys and adults alike began to grow hungry and there was nothing to feed them. Fast forward about an hour and a half, the two waltz into the cabin, and the food was then unloaded and brought into the kitchen. On Boy Scout trips, meals are prepared by a scout or scouts, often to satisfy a requirement or to complete cooking merit badge. The cook began separating ingredients and took out his recipe. While diligently working, Eck comes up to talk to C. "Eck, you don't have to cook for me, I already ate." "C, I'm preparing meals for everyone." "Wait, what do you mean you already ate?" "Eck, my mommy took me to get friendlies." C notices the empty milkshake cup. "Literally what? You guys had the food in your car." By then Eck was disinterested and went away. However, this word spread quickly throughout the group, and nobody was happy. M was also doing some other not cool stuff, like calling bathroom breaks potty stops and treating all of us, even my brother and I who are a junior and sophomore respectively, like we were 10 years old. Granted, Eck has got some clear issues, but his behavior is inexcusable and clearly a result of appeasement by the mother. She also brags about sitting on a number of committees within the local scouting governing body, which is painfully ironic considering she has demonstrated the least scout-like behavior I've seen on any event ever. Morals of the story: don't be an entitled shitstin, be conscious of your actions, don't use scouts as an occupation for your fucked up kid, and if you're a mom, I give you my humble request to not go on Boy Scout trips. It creates trouble whether intended or not. Also, if you're in Philadelphia, go get steaks at Jim's South Saint. It was the highlight of this trip for me. Thank you. Next. Short but annoying story about an entitled mother I encountered the other day. Further down the block from where I live is an elementary school. Due to some poor planning, older part of town, the entrance to the school is on a one-way, one-lane street. During school drop-off slash pickup hours, I know to avoid the area. But during the day the area is fairly quiet and it's actually the quickest way for me to get home. Such is what happened the other day. I ran some errands in the morning and then headed home to get to work. As I got to the school, the car in front of me slowed down and then stopped. I thought the driver was perhaps picking someone up or dropping off someone who was late, but what happened instead is that the driver shut the engine, hit the hazards and exited the car and began heading into the school. I immediately honked to grab her attention. But as all Karens are possessed of an internal mechanism that blocks out all irritating noises beyond the screech of other Karens calling for support from the coven, I was summarily ignored. Cars began piling up behind me, and Karen is nowhere to be found. All that's left for me to do is stew in my own increasingly boiling pot of anger and outrage. I'll be honest, I considered just leaning on the horn until she came back, but I knew it'd do no good and I'd just bother the kids studying. About 15 minutes later, Karen came back, strolling along without a care in the world. When we saw her, she was greeted with a cacophony of car horns, yelling and cursing, but her deflector shields were up and she heard not a thing of the abuse we hurled her way. She got in the car and drove off, and I got home a few minutes later. To add insult to injury, there were parking spots about 50 feet up the road, but she didn't even bother trying to go once around the block to look for spots. That's it. That's all there is to the story. Just an entitled person who couldn't possibly comprehend that a public road is not her personal parking lot. No instant karma, no justice or revenge bonus, just sheer frustration. However, for the sake of the story and to make you all feel better, all of us who were stuck behind her banded together, called the cops and confronted her. She was arrested for assaulting a police officer and filing false claims after she took a swing at the cops because they didn't believe her when she told the cops we gang raped her in front of the school guard while threatening to shoot her, her kids and shoot up the school. Thank you. Next. This was originally posted on Choosing Beggars, and a few people suggested I repost it here too, so here it is.